Do you ever find employee interviews a little daunting? Today I have 6 tips for conducting a successful interview.
It's Thirsty Thursday. You're so thirsty, thirsty Thursday. Thirsty for knowledge, thirsty Thursday. Drink it up.
The first tip I have for you seems pretty simple and maybe even obvious to some of you, but it's really important that you know the job description, because so many people show up to an interview and the person doing the interview either doesn't have the job description, doesn't necessarily know exactly what the job will entail, or worse, they kind of use just a very generic interview style rather than really learning if this person is right for this particular job. So before you conduct an interview, make sure that you review the job description multiple times, that you're familiar with it, and you know exactly what is needed in order for your interviewee to fulfill the role. Once you've thoroughly reviewed the job description, now you want to lay out a list of all of the trainable skills for the job and then those skills that are actually required. For instance, if I'm hiring for a leasing position, it might be important to me that I have someone who is able to do some marketing, but I may not require that they have marketing experience because I can train them in those areas. So if I have an applicant that doesn't have marketing experience, it won't necessarily eliminate them from the position. But I will want to know more about how trainable they are and their experience in being trained in new tasks, and maybe their level of creativity. Next, I want to prepare some situational questions that are centered around those required skills. So for instance, let's say I'm interviewing a candidate for a property management role, and problem-solving skills is something that I have identified as a required skill for this role. Then I might ask a question that centers around a problem that they solved in their previous role. The next tip to help you conduct a successful interview is to do a pre-interview. Once you've determined who you want to interview, be sure that you're doing a phone interview first to get some of those basic things out of the way, those automatic eliminators. Things like if you're hiring for a maintenance technician who needs to be on call and you want to find out if this person can take calls at nights or on weekends every other week, that's something you can do over the phone without bringing them into the office for an interview. And if they're unable to meet those basic job requirements, then you know there's no need to meet them in person. This allows them to familiarize themselves with you, maybe gather more information about the company, and come prepared to an in-person interview with some questions for you and less nerves. And if you do that pre-interview and decide that you want to meet someone in person, they're much more likely to show up to that in-person interview because you've already connected with them over the phone and they feel like, oh, this is my second interview. This is getting very serious. I have a more likely chance of actually getting this job. Next, you'll want to remember that the candidates are interviewing you just as much as you are interviewing them. So you want to try to ensure that you tell them about all of the great reasons that they would want to work for your company. Be sure that you have information available to them about the benefits that they'll have by working with you and your team. Be prepared to answer their questions and ask them if they have any questions or information that they'd like, so that you can be sure that at the end of that interview, they have everything that they need to know to determine if they want to work for your company and in turn, you. And finally, when a candidate comes in for an in-person interview, you want to create a more casual setting. Rather than you sit across the desk from them and interrogate them about why you should choose them as a new employee, create an opportunity to help them calm their nerves. Remember that they're there because they want to impress you so that they can get a job. They need to work, and they want to work for you. Otherwise, they wouldn't have shown up. So it's really important to create an environment where you can really have a conversation rather than an interrogation. So choose a space that is not going to be conducive to interruptions. Choose a space that's private, but also one where you can casually sit side by side or at least without barriers in between you. And then remember that they want to know as much about you as you want to know about them. So allow them that opportunity during that conversation. Use these 6 tips and you will be conducting more successful interviews. Have a great day and be inspired. Hi, I'm Katie Rigsby, multifamily consultant and speaker, otherwise known as the Multifamily Maven. I want to personally thank you for watching my video. And if you found this information helpful or encouraging, give it a thumbs up or share it with someone that you know. If you want to get new content fresh off the presses every Monday and Thursday, then go to my YouTube channel and subscribe. Be sure to click the little bell so you'll get a reminder and you won't miss out. And while you're on my channel, look through all the past videos and see what else is out there, what kind of topics that you might be interested in. And if you're looking for anything specific, feel free to comment. Let me know what it is that you want more information about or ideas that you're looking for. I'd love to interact with you and give you exactly what it is that you need. So make sure that you like, share, and subscribe so that you can get new, fresh ideas and encouragement from me every Monday and Thursday. Thanks again for watching. Have a great day and be inspired.